Hi, I meet metallizers all over the world and they ask normally a fixed set of questions. Two of the questions invariably people ask me is, what if a boat fails during mid-cycle, what should we be doing? And what are two component boats, what are three component boats, which one should be used? These are the two major questions that I face. First, about me, I am Anshuman Punch. I am an engineer by qualification. I am founder CEO of Superbike Industries LLP. At Superbike, we supply all kinds of consumables like evaporation boats, vacuum oils to around 500 metallizers in 37 countries. I'm also a technical blogger and a published author and an inventor too. Now coming to these questions. First question, what if a boat fails mid-cycle? As we understand in metallizing, the film unwinds from a roll and winds on another roll, and in between deposition drum is there, under which boats are arranged in a series, say A, B, C, D, E, F, G. At fixed intervals, boats are fixed like this. Now, suppose boat B fails. In this case, the appropriate action would be to increase the power as well as the wire feed to boat A and C if B boat has failed. This will result in an increased vaporization at A and C. So, the cloud of vapor will increase in both these boats. That will compensate the less evaporation at taking place at boat B or no evaporation at taking place at boat B. Metallizing will not suffer, and after the cycle is completed, the boats can be replaced. This can save a lot of wastage that otherwise takes place. A lot of film gets wasted, and if we have to break the vacuum and start the process again, so a lot of time also, production time also gets wasted. So this procedure avoids these two. Second question I normally face is, what are two or three component boats and which one should be used? Now, as we understand, in a boat, the current has to pass so that it can get heated up. At the same time, there has to be a resistance to the current, otherwise heating of the boat will not take place. So, for passing of the current, a conducting element, that is titanium dioboride, is added. And for resisting the flow of the current, an insulating element, that is boron nitride, is added. These two are mixed so that current flows but with resistance, heating up the boat in the process. So, titanium dioboride and boron nitride, this is a two-component boat, typically used by metallizers. Then there is a three component boat also. In three component boat, boron nitride partly is substituted with aluminium nitride. So since aluminium nitride is somewhat cheaper than boron nitride, the cost comes down. Now a question, that should we be using two component boat or three component boat? Then as per my experience, in a three component boat, the price of the boat comes down typically by 7 to 9% because of it. We are using a cheaper element, but the life of the boat reduces from 15 to 25%. So this is not a good bargain, this is a bad bargain. I will always say, go for two component evaporation boats. Thank you so much for watching. Please do visit www.supervacoils.com and go to the blogspot.